being on 7th.
And watch the state of Israel murdering our people en masse, killing 2,000 people in cold blood, and justifying that by saying we send the missile as a knock on the roof to allow for people to exit their homes. No longer will we allow the murder of 400 of our children. No longer will we stand silent while our water bombs drop on our schools and drop on our hospitals and drop on our water wells while they build on our farms. No longer will we stand silently. It is time that we transform our words into action through boycotts, divestment, and sanctions against the apartheid state of Israel. Where people worldwide stood up to the apartheid regime in South Africa and said no more to racist colonialism in South Africa. Many of us who fought in that struggle stood up against corporations like Coca-Cola, but also stood up against the ZIM liner that traded with apartheid South Africa, Huta and Feinstein brought right here to the Bay Area in order to conduct business with the Bay Area, with apartheid South African goods. Later on, they lied to the public and they declared that they pulled out of South Africa even though they had not. This is the same company that participated in the establishment of the State of Israel with the help of the Jewish National Fund and the Jewish Agency. They transported billions of dollars worth of weaponry to the State of Israel. They have transported settlers to occupy Palestine as they ethnically cleansed our people and bombed us out of Haifa, out of Akka, out of Yaffa, out of Jerusalem. But the Palestinian people are resilient. For 67 years, the State of Israel has been trying to crush our spirits, just like the State of South Africa, the apartheid regime in South Africa, the colonial white regime in South Africa, tried to crush the indigenous people of South Africa, and people resisted and overthrew that racist regime. Let this be known that on August 16, 2014, we are conducting the second historical boycott against the apartheid regime in Israel. And let us mark today as the beginning of the end of the racist Zionist rule in Palestine.
Yeah!
Israel today says that they are giving us a choice. Either they'll go back to bombing Gaza and kidnapping children out of the West Bank in the middle of the night and bombing refugee camps in Lebanon by imposing the siege on Gaza that has continued for 7 years, blocking medical supplies and books and milk, or we face the prospect of yet another aggression. The people of Gaza have spoken loud and clear. They have made a call to the rest of the world, to all of us, and they said We would rather die under the bombs of the Israeli arsenal than die quietly under the quiet genocide of the siege. The Palestinian people have chosen the path of resistance. And we, in the international community, have chosen the path of justice. And the way we stood up with the indigenous people of South Africa against the white racist regime over there, we stand with the indigenous people of Palestine against the Zionist colonial white regime that has been established by the State of Israel. Brothers and sisters, we have a long program ahead of us. We have a long march, but the march to freedom is never short. And the march to freedom today requires us that we block the gates of berth 57 where the apartheid ship, the ZIM liner, is supposed to dock. I would like to call to the mic the Arab Youth Organization speakers.
Thank you. at the coalition?
I'm in the coalition working on the.
It is for that reason that we came here, and we are happy to tell you that the Zimliner decided to stay out at sea. This is a statement I just received from the organizers. The ZIM pairs arrived in Northern California by afternoon yesterday. It could have docked by early Saturday morning. We held the ZIM off in place due to our readiness and mobilization at 5 a.m. We showed up again at 3 p.m. to stop the scheduled work crews from unloading the ship. Our action today have sent a clear message that genocide and apartheid does not pay in Oakland. Our actions today have sent a clear message that genocide and apartheid does not pay in Oakland or anywhere on the West Coast. Because as you may know, there were people down at Long Beach and up in Seattle and Tacoma and Vancouver willing and ready to block the ZIM liner had it decided to go to Seattle or Vancouver or Tacoma or Long Beach. We have stopped the ZIM Piraeus from docking on the west coast of the United States on August 16, 2014. Our actions, along with the hundreds of thousands of people who mobilized worldwide in solidarity with the resilient Palestinian people, should send a clear and resounding message that the beginning of the end for the Zionist apartheid regime in Palestine is upon us. As South African apartheid fell, the Israeli Zionist apartheid regime will fall. Thank you. Free, free Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
Long live Palestine!
Long live Palestine!
We block the boat! We block the boat!
The boat!
We block the boat! We block the boat! We block the boat! We block the boat! We block the boat! We block the boat! We block the boat! We block the boat! We block the boat! Thank you, every single one of you guys that came out here. Once again, my name is Sameh and I'm with AO, and we want to give a round of applause to everybody that came out here. Everybody that came out to tell this ZIM ship that we do not want your Israeli goods in San Francisco. We don't want them in the West Coast. We don't want them in America. We don't want them around the world. We don't even want Israel in the Middle East. So when we stand up and tell this ZIM ship that you're not allowed to come in here, and we blocked the boat before we even got to the Port of Oakland, that's a round of applause for every single one of you guys out here. And thank you all, you guys.
All right, guys, we're going to continue marching down to the port. So let's go.
Free, free, Palestine!
Free, 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 Palestine!
Free, 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 Palestine!
And then the accusation!
And the accusation!
Free, 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 Palestine!
Free, 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 Palestine!
And then the occupation! Thank you.
lifesaver. Thank you.
I'm just a helper.
Nice coffee. You gotta be kidding me, man. We must be in the Bay Area. No. Thank you.
Time to go.
Lifesaver, thank you.
I'm just a helper.
Nice coffee.
A sterling example for the entire working class.
important slogan that I've heard yesterday. What you need to understand, I'm a longshoreman. I make my living right here. But what you have done is have these ZIM vessels reluctant to come in because you're here.
It's in the website, you can look at it and read it. First, The people of Gaza are the people who stood up and in solidarity with people in Egypt, with people in the revolt in South Africa against apartheid, and now they are standing firm shoulder to shoulder with the people of Kurdistan against racism, against the killing of innocents. So we understand the people of Gaza, particularly the workers, have a message for the workers here that we appreciate their support, but we want to continue. We want to continue. We will continue to block the boat. We will continue to do in the apartheid in Israel, just like we in the apartheid in South Africa. We are saying, people in Gaza are saying that we are tired of those people looking at people of Gaza as bitches, children and victims. But we want to hold people responsible for this.
Yeah.
We want to hold white people responsible for killing a human being and genocide that is taking place against the Palestinian in Gaza. I am very proud to see that as we speak today, your brothers and sisters in Chicago are protesting by Boeing. Boeing are the machine, the killer, the manufacturers who manufactured the killing machine of F-16 and F-17. We're protesting that company. We need to apply the pressure to make sure that if the United States continue to support the racist state of Israel, will continue to be by itself and isolated, just like my brother Richard Becker has said earlier. We are no longer going to tolerate the fact that Israel is untouchable, or there is a taboo. We cannot criticize Israel. Israel is so and so. No, we need to name the names of our aggressors. You are not going to be in a footing, in a position where you have to defend people who are defending themselves. The first question the media will ask us is, oh, don't you think that Israel has the right to defend itself? Yeah, the strongest force army in the whole world, the strongest force in the world, are killing people. 15,000 tons of explosives on civilians. Enough is enough. And I wanted to congratulate us for doing this today. We have won a small victory, gonna accumulate another victory, and we wanna say, power of the people. There's no power like the power of the people. It's the power of the people. Never stop.
Yeah.
I wanna say thank you, everybody that's here. Give yourselves a round of applause.
Yeah.
Chairperson of the League of Filipino Students at San Francisco State University, and I'm here with representing the National League of People Struggles and Bayan USA. We are part of the National Democratic Movement, and we stand in solidarity with the people of Palestine. We recognize that the atrocities that are happening in Ferguson, that are happening in Palestine, that are happening in the Philippines, are all the same problem. We are all suffering underneath the hands of U.S. imperialism. It is because of U.S. imperialism that we are out of our homeland, that we must be here, that we are not back with our families, that we are seeing our brothers and sisters being killed every day. We do not just see it happening in Palestine, we see it happening here in the U.S. We stand with all of our black and brown brothers and sisters who are fighting every day to be free. We must recognize that it is not in our power alone that we can end U.S. imperialism. We must come together to arouse, organize, and mobilize together. Because it's the power of the people, don't stop. Say what? The power of the people, don't stop. The power of the people, don't stop. Say what? On behalf of ILBS and Bayan USA, that we're all fighting for. So I just want you guys to know that we're not going to leave it here on the streets. We're going to go over there in our classrooms, in our homes. We're going to overpower the social media that is corrupting these youth's minds, even us. We're going to use social media, Facebook, any kind, newspapers, flyers, everything, so that we can educate the people out there. What they are doing is wrong. Boys and girls, the empathy movement starts right here and is in our hearts. And my dedication is to teach the youth what they're doing, Gaza, is wrong. Innocent people are dying. My Filipino brothers and sisters in the Philippines are dying because of the occupation of the U.S. in there. So now I want you guys to remember, if you can't remember every speech that you have heard, remember the empathy movement is starting, and it's starting now.
Yeah.
With a chant, and it's in Tagalog. Woo! So, it's going to be hard. Break it down. Maki baka.
Maki baka.
Wag masaga.
Wag masaga.
Dare to struggle.
Dare to struggle.
Don't be afraid.
Don't be afraid.
Maki baka.
Maki baka.
Maki baka.
Maki baka.
Wag masaga.
Maki baka.
Maki baka.
Wag masaga.
Don't be afraid.
Don't be afraid.
Don't be afraid.
Don't be afraid.
Dare to struggle.
Dare to struggle.
Hands up. Don't shoot.
Don't shoot.
Don't shoot. Hands up. Don't shoot. Don't shoot.
I left the injured money, so I wouldn't come up with a dead
battery.
You got a microphone in that thing?
Yeah.
Do you?
Uh-huh.
I'll do a piece for you.
Sure, sure.
But, so you go.
Yeah, go.
Yeah, my name is Peter. I'm the king of street theater, otherwise known as Cactus Pete, often bitter, sometimes sweet. And up my sleeve, I got more than one trick, and the bad guys I write about have called me a prick. I cannot understand how it is that we have 2,000-3,000 people here and they spend two hours like it's a picnic and then they go back home when the people they're complaining about are going 24/7 for the last 20 years abusing us, murdering us, not just in Palestine but here in this country. I talked to the cops up there and I said, well, we might have to have the cops shut down the West Coast until D.C. is toast. Martin Luther King saw the promised land and I, Peter, I'm here to tell you that the 40-day strike walks us into the promised land. It's a spiritual deal. That's why Gandhi stopped being a lawyer, because he knew that the answer would not be within the system. It's a spiritual answer, and that's called shutting down this entire system of cancer. Only then can we proceed with what needs to happen. It's a spiritual deal with Leonard Peltier, the number one political spiritual prisoner in the world, who represents the 500-year indigenous resistance worldwide, and in his cell is the living, breathing spirit of the U.S. Constitution, which many say was a God-given gift, and it was gifted to our forefathers, they say, but originally it was given to us by the Iroquois, and that is why Leonard Peltier is of severe import. As long as he stays in prison, nothing changes. We have the power to shut it down. We have 3,000 people here, enough to maintain a presence of at least 500 people here every hour of the day for the next 40 days, and the port would shut down. Not only that, but the longshoremen want to see Leonard Peltier and Mumia Abu-Jamal set free. They're willing to strike, but we have to strike first. But these people, they show up, and I don't know who's leading them or what they're thinking, but there is no power. Because a power, an action is only as powerful as what it attains. And Martin Luther King,
and Gandhi and Cesar Chavez and Harry Bridges showed us that the power is attained by a lengthy action. And these one-day, half-a-day deals accomplishes nothing. All it does is say, continue killing Israel, continue the bad cops, continue killing kids in this country. It is the people that were here that are allowing this to happen more than anybody else, because California, my friends, is the most powerful state in the world. We have the power to open up the promised land. They say Israel is the promised land. It's true, but it's not a speck of dust across the sea. Israel has another name. It's called Ariel. It means the world. America represents the world, and California is the shit. We have all the power. We got 29 ports that would be willing within 3 days to shut down when we shut down this port. They want to set these brothers free.